Good morning, students. In last period, we will start our 13th chapter. 13th chapter name is data handling. Then next point is making a bar graph. Next point of this chapter is making a bar graph. In a bar graph, bar shows the collected data. In a bar graph, bar shows the collected data. Let us consider an example for making a bar graph. Let us consider an example for making a bar graph. Then, for example, in a class, teacher asked from his 20 students which food item they like most, and the answers are. In a class, teacher asked from his 20 students which food item they like most, and the answers are. First one is pizza, burger, samosa, ice cream, pizza. Fifth one is also pizza. Then making a bar graph using above data. We have given 20 students. Then make a bar graph. Step first is make a frequency distribution table of the collected data. Make a frequency distribution table of the collected data, that is food. First column is food and second column is number of students. In food, pizza, samosa, burger and ice cream, and number of students are, in pizza number of students are 7, in samosa number of students are 5, in burgers number of students are 5, ice cream number of students are 3. Then step 2 is make 2 axes. One is horizontal x and other one is vertical y. Make 2 axes. One is horizontal x and one is vertical y. That is horizontal axis x and vertical axis y. At the point of intersection of this axis, the value is 0, which called the origin. At the point of intersection of this axis, at the point of intersection of this axis, the value is 0, which is called origin. Then step 3 is now represent the food item on x-axis and number of students on y-axis. Now represented food items on x-axis and number of students on y-axis. Then first one is pizza, samosa, burger and ice cream. There are 4 food items and in y-axis number of students 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Then we have given in step first food and number of students. Then in pizza number of students are 7. Then we draw this graph at point 7. Then next one is in samosa number of students are 5. Then this is graph of samosa. Next burger number of students are also 5. Then graph is similar to samosa. Then next one ice cream number of students are 3. Then graph is this way. Then this is bar graph. Step 4 is consider one box represents one student. Step first is consider one box represents one student. Then step 5 is count the number of students like pizza and the shade or color. These numbers of number of boxes vertically. Seven students like pizza. Similarly, color of for burger, samosa and ice cream is similarly color of burger, samosa and ice cream. Then next we have given exercise 13.1. टू. फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल इज अ सर्वे इज डन इन अ सोसाइटी टू फाइंड विच इज कलर ऑफ द विच कलर द किड्स लाइक द मोस्ट एंड द रिजल्ट इट इज अंडर. देन वी हैव गिवन कलर्स एंड नंबर ऑफ किड्स. इन रेड कलर 16 किड्स आर लाइक. देन इन ग्रीन कलर 4 स्टूडेंट्स आर लाइक. ब्लू कलर 2 स्टूडेंट्स आर लाइक. येलो कलर 18 स्टूडेंट्स आर लाइक. एंड पर्पल कलर 10 स्टूडेंट्स आर लाइक. देन वी हैव टू मेक अ बार ग्राफ. देन स्टेप फर्स्ट इज मेक अ फ्रिक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन टेबल ऑन द कलेक्टेड डाटा. देन इन दिस कलेक्ट वी हैव राइट दिस फ्रिक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन टेबल. स्टेप सेकंड इज मेक टू एक्सिस इज हॉरिजेंटल एक्स एंड वन वर्टिकल. वन इज हॉरिजेंटल एक्स एंड वन इज वर्टिकल वाई. मेक टू स्टेप टू इज मेक टू एक्सिस. वन इज वर्टिकल एक्स वर्टिकल वाई एंड हॉरिजेंटल एक्स एक्सिस. देन स्टेप थ्री now represent colors of the axis. Now represent colors on x axis and number of kids on y axis. Then make a bar graph in previous as for previous example. Then next our next point is line graph. Our next point is line graph. Line graph is a graph in which line segments are used to connect data points and show change in data over time. Line graph is a graph in which line segments are used to connect. Line graph is a graph in which line segments are used to connect data points and show changes in data over time. Then, for example, Neha recorded her test scores in a line graph as shows. We have given one graph on x-axis, horizontal axis. Number of subject, we have given x axis subject, and on y axis vertical axis marks scored. Then what is Neha's score in maths test? We have to tell Neha's score in maths. Here it is maths. Then Neha's score in maths is 60 marks. Then in which subject does she scored highest marks? In which subject he scored highest marks? Then in social studies it gave highest mark, that is 100 out of 100. Then next one point is how to read a line graph. Then solution is the height of each point in the graph represents Neha's score in the particular subject. Point A is the height of the point for maths is 60. So Neha scored 60 in maths test. Then height of the highest point is 100. That is, it is social studies. So Neha scored 100 marks in social studies. Our next point is how to make a line graph. Here are steps for making a line graph. Step first is draw two lines, one horizontal and other vertical, intersecting each other as shown below. The vertical axis is represented as a axis and the vertical as the y-axis. The place where the lines cross each other is called the origin and marked as a zero. Here, vertical axis is y-axis, horizontal axis is existence and these two axes intersect at point O, then this is origin of that axis. Then step 2 is label each axis, x axis as a month and y axis as a temperature. Say, label each axis, x axis as months and y axis as the temperature. Then step 3 is identify the range of data you have to include for each variable. Identify the range of data you have to include for the variable. Draw both axes according to your range of data, the highest and the lowest. Then first on x axis we have given months and on y axis we have given temperature. Then step 4 is decide how many units every line on the graph represent for each of your variable. You might designate a scale of 5 degrees Celsius per line to measure temperature along y-axis. We have given on y-axis a scale 5 degrees Celsius per line, that is 0 to 5 is 5 degrees Celsius, 5 to 10 is also 5 degrees Celsius. Then next term we have given temperature in Celsius 0, 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. Then here months are January, February and March. Then step 5 is plot your data on the graph. For example, if the temperature of January was 10 degrees Celsius,